as Curtis Granderson. He grew up here. He played college ball at UIC. He was a three-time All-Star over 16 years in the major leagues. That is a career right there. Since he retired, he has been incredibly active in youth baseball here in Chicago. And now he is doing something special to celebrate Jackie Robinson Day. So you've been doing this now, so 8 years you've been doing this. And you've done an incredible job. And, you know, it's like, how have you done it? Because a lot of kids don't want to play baseball now, especially kids who live in the city don't want to play baseball now. What has your approach been? How have you gotten so many kids wanting to play?
Our biggest thing is just showing how fun and exciting it was and letting them realize how cool it was for me.
Yeah.
And going, these are some of the opportunities that can come your way, especially when we get them a chance to play on a college campus at UIC. That's a Division I school, arguably the best view in all of baseball.
Yeah.
So when they step on the field as young as 8 years old, all the way up to now with the CPS varsity's kids, and their eyes just open up and go, I get to play here? Like, yeah, you can play here, yeah. And you could potentially go to school, not only here, but any of these universities. So those are the exciting things that I try to push for them, and they just eat it up.
I like how you casually mentioned one of the best stadiums in college. Yeah, because it's named after you. You got us. You're four, what are you, 43? 43, because stadiums are normally, you know, named after boring old billionaires. You're, that is heady, man. That you got a, what does that mean to you that you have a baseball stadium named after you?
That's just so cool. You know, probably the biggest thing that stands out to me, if you go on the Google Maps, you can actually find the dot there and get directions to the stadium, and it says Curtis Granderson Stadium. But it's so weird to say that name. I always call it CG Stadium.
Yeah.
But the fact that we have this amazing stadium, again, with the best view in all of baseball, home for the UIC Flames, but all these kids throughout the city of Chicago get a chance to be on there throughout the course of the year, and that's the most exciting thing for me.
Yeah, the organization you founded in 2016, the Chicago Baseball and Education Academy. Tell me a little bit about that and the event that's coming up. It's the 11th through the 14th. I mentioned, obviously, 80 CPS teams are playing, but how did the CBEA come to be and this event come to be?
In 2016, when we founded Chicago Baseball Educational Academy, I made the donation to UIC for the stadium, but in part of having that donation, I said, not only do I want the UIC Flames to play there, but I also want to make this home for all these kids that live within walking distance, mm-hmm. within the blue line, within the 8 bus, all these areas to come on this field and get a chance to play. And we just talked about the weather right before we came out. And you know how Chicago is.
Yeah.
It's 70 today, but it could be snowing next week.
Right.
So when these kids are practicing on their fields throughout the city of Chicago, if it rains, if it's snow, if it's cold, then all of a sudden baseball is off. But the great thing about UIC allowing us to use the facility for CBEA, we are the largest indoor facility in the city of Chicago that offers everything for free. So you can go inside in the winter months, you can come outside when we have great weather on the weekend like we had this year, and it happens all year long.
Yeah, I mean, you're making an incredible impact, but a guy I like to call the Curtis Granderson of youth softball is our own Paul Konrad,
nice.
Who's very involved, and I know you've worked with him a little bit. You can level with me. I mean, what is he doing for the future of softball in this city? I mean, does he know what the hell he's doing?
You know what? Here's the thing. As long as he's talking about the 16-inch softball, you know, then he's going. Not the 12-inch.
Right.
The Chicago-style 16-inch clincher. That's the one he's got to be talking about.
That's what I'll start focusing on.
I want to talk about your career a little bit. I mean, I mentioned it at the top. You know, 16 years, you know, very few people play 16 years in the bigs. You played in some great cities, too. I'm curious, where was your favorite place to play? Can you narrow it down? Was New York? I mean,
so interesting. A lot of people assume it's New York, and I had Jeter over there, and Ichiro, A-Rod, Cano, and then I was also with the Mets. Went to the World Series with David Wright and Lucas Duda, one of my best buds in the game. But I got to go to where it started, and that was the Detroit Tigers.
Yeah.
They drafted me. I made it to the big leagues with them. I went to my first World Series with them. I was about to buy my second home there and then got traded to the Yankees that same week that it all ended up happening. So didn't end up getting a place there, but Detroit was the place that started it for me.
I was looking at a lot of the teams you played on, and there were a couple of down years for the teams, but by and large, like most of the teams you played for, winning teams. And then, you know, I'm looking at the White Sox right now and just the stretch they're in. And, I know you've got to obviously see what's going on there. What do you think these guys, how do you get motivated every day to come to the park like that when you're losing guys left and right and things are just spiraling this quickly?
I think the biggest thing is to realize that injuries do happen. You're not the only team going through it, especially when we're talking about the pitchers right now. So many pitchers getting hurt, but now you have injuries affecting your own team. you have these bonds with these teammates as your friends. You're with them so much throughout the course of the year. But as long as we can focus on one game at a time, we can't win the previous games. We can't win games in September because it's only April right now.
Yeah.
Focus on each game at a time. Say, let's win this game. Let's win this series. Then when the next series come, let's start with winning this game and win a series. And slowly but surely, you could have a slow start to the season and finish up amazing. Get ready, get hot by the All-Star break, make a couple trades, and you can have the place rocking come September.
Good Lord, you should be a motivational speaker for that pitch. Hey, I'm going to give another pitch for you. More than 80 CPS varsity teams playing this weekend to honor Jackie Robinson. Several marquee games, again, are in Crestwood and Curtis Granderson Stadium at UIC. For more info, go to cbeauic.org. Curtis, thanks so much. Good having you.
Thanks for having me.